We're gonna catch a big crab. We're gonna cook it.
Show me.
Hi, my name is Lucho. This is my first mate, Anna. And together with our baby boat Ceviche, we're gonna discover the Chesapeake Bay. Come with us.
Follow us.
Well, this is the beautiful Chesapeake Bay. In this episode, we're going to depart from Annapolis, down the bay about, I think it's about 10 miles from Annapolis. That's beautiful, Annapolis. 10 miles from Annapolis down the bay to Shady Side. Shady Side, it's a nice little area in the bay. We're gonna be doing some work on the boats. The dealership is located there. And we're also gonna visit some of the local restaurants and spots. Check it out, Shady Side.
Baby, so leaving Annapolis. Bye, Annapolis. You've been good. All the sailboats. See you later. So we're going to Shady Side, right, baby? We're going to Shady Side. We're going to go to the dealer because the boat, you know, just regular maintenance and just some warranty little things here and there that I want them to take care of. And then we'll come back to Annapolis. So we'll see. Hopefully, just a few days. The bay is beautiful today. Woo! Baby, leaving Annapolis. It's a beautiful day. Wow. Good job, baby. We see a bunch of birds, fish jumping, so we always try to give it a little try. Maybe we fish something. We're not very lucky lately, but we never give up. Right, baby? So here is the iconic Thomas Point Shoal Lighthouse, one of the most classic picturesque lighthouses here in the Chesapeake Bay, one of the most famous, where the big famous pictures, the postcards are. Very nice. Check out the crab boat, you know, picking up the crab pots and harvesting the delicious Maryland blue crab. Good job, buddy. Baby, we made it to Shady Side in our dealership, Clark's Landing Marina. We're gonna leave the boat here, you know, for a few days. Well, they take care of some stuff and some maintenance. It's a nice, really nice little place. Well kept, nice guys so far. Baby, we're back. We're back in Ceviche. We left about a week. We went back to the apartment in DC. We left the boat here at the dealership. And, you know, they had some warranty work to do, so we didn't want to be in their way, and we left. But we're back. I mean, we were really missing to be back. Once you live in a boat, you don't want to live anywhere else. I'm telling you. So living in DC in the apartment is nice, but living here is just an everyday adventure. So we're back after a week missing the boat every day. And now we're leaving the dealership and we're gonna go to the Shady Side area. So we're gonna go to Pyro's Cove. Nice little restaurant, good seafood, just a good ambience. We're gonna hang out there. Hopefully they have live music. Let's do it, baby! Woo! Baby, let's go! Leaving the marina. Man, what a beautiful day. Being back in the boat is definitely the feeling I wanted. Check this out. Wow. What a life. Baby, we're here. Pyro's Cove. Nice. We had to take the end of the dock because all the docks are taken. But we're here. You know, we're looking forward for a nice dinner. Should be nice. It's a busy weekend. See all the sailboats here. How you doing? Good, good. All the sailboats here, a few trawlers. Definitely a busy weekend. And this is the place. Pyro's Cove Marina in Shady Side, Chesapeake Bay. Nice. All right, baby, are you ready for some seafood? Chesapeake Bay seafood or what?
I do, can't wait.
Yeah, we get Pyro's Cove in Shady Side. Nice place, nice marina. We've been here before. We really like it. Hello. Cheers, baby. We are back here in the Chesapeake Bay, Cove Pirates. Look at that. Sitting outside, good music, good live music. Definitely a fun time. Our boat is out there. The menu is just amazing. We're ordering all kinds of stuff. Baby, we're back. I missed it. In just 1 week, I really missed it. 10 days. Baby, crab balls here are amazing with the oyster Rockefeller. And the tuna tartare, that's not local, but it's good. Enjoy, baby. Waking up here in Shady Side on a beautiful Sunday. Check it out. Man, we're having breakfast. And I made some iced coffee, iced latte. Baby, look at this day. Look at this, wow. Man, this is life. Beautiful Sunday, baby. Soon we're gonna go brunch, right? I want some oysters, some crabs, something good, the way we like it. Let's enjoy, baby. Another beautiful day. Woo! Baby! Well, show us how the Chesapeake Bay people do it, baby. Check this out. Every marina has traps. They said like 10 traps running all weekend. Check this out. Look at that, huge crabs. And then on Sunday at 5, they do a big feast. Everybody's invited. Wow, check it out. Incredible, baby. This is Chesapeake life. Woo! Nice. Thank you for a ride. I know a little.
place we can get there for the break of day.
Let's go to brunch.
Baby, what? Is this she? No way, Jose.
No way, Jose.
Baby, these oysters are nice and fresh. With my Bloody Mary. Woo, how about you? Check this out.
This is what I call a nice brunch in the Chesapeake Bay.
Woo! Good job, baby. Baby, this salad is nice and fresh. Check it out.
Mama, rapid.
Okay, baby. Shh. We're gonna catch a big crab. We're gonna cook it.
Show me, show me.
You got it, baby.
You got it.
Look at him. All right. This is gonna be rice, seafood rice. Look at that. Check him out, baby. Wow, we got it. It's a big one too. Woohoo! Nice. Be careful. Be careful. Be careful.
Love it.
We got it, baby! Woohoo!
Bravo!
Now, crab rice. Yeah. Baby, so I'm gonna show you how to do seafood crab rice. Okay? So you get your rice ready with all the spices, including some Old Bay, of course. Right? So you get all the spices in the rice and the water in the rice maker. And then you get your crab, your blue crab, you cut it in half. And then you just stick it in there. The point is to get all the juices, protein, all the flavor from the crab into your rice. At the end, you can take some of the meat out and put it in there. But the main point is to get the flavor out of the crab into your rice. So the rice will taste like, you know, crab, seafood, really good. And after that, you're gonna refry it. You can add chicken, you can add, you know, sausages, almost like a paella, you know, you can add whatever you want. But your rice itself, the base of the rice, is gonna taste amazing. Check it out, baby. That's it. There it is, my crab rice. It's gonna taste amazing. It's gonna take 15 minutes. And then we'll take it out, and we'll put it in a fry pan, and we'll add extra meats and stuff, whatever we want. It's gonna be good. Good job, baby.
Yeah.
Baby, let's check out the result of the crab rice. Ta-ta-ta-tang. Check it out.
Can't believe it.
Look at that. Look at this. Crab is cooked. All the flavor is in the rice.
Show me, baby.
Look, baby. The crab is cooked. All the flavor is in the rice. Check it out. put it in the plate. We can pick some of the meat later. But this is it.
Good job, baby.
Good job. Good job, baby. Check this out. So I got a little color, you know, from the crab. Yeah, this is gonna be really good. Then we'll throw it in the fry pan. We add some more stuff, meats, whatever, you know, or more seafood.
It'll
be amazing. Woo! Baby, leaving the dealership. They finally do all the repairs. Well, a couple of things that are still left. They're ordering the parts. We told them we come back in closer to the fall to install those parts that we're waiting for. Nothing big, you know, little things like you know, like the back shower, but I have a tape on it, so it still works. So leaving, I think we're heading to Annapolis. And we're gonna be there for the weekend, and then we're going north, you know, river by river, town by town. It's gonna be good. It's gonna be the rest of the summer continues. We're in the middle of the summer, so the summer continues. We have 2-3 more months, right, baby, of traveling through the Chesapeake Bay. So we're really looking forward. Good times. Baby in automatic pilot, drinking a michelada, you know, just chilling at sailboat speed, about 6-7 knots. Relax, walk around, have a drink. Relaxing, you know, the bay. We have 2-3 hours to get there. It's gonna be nice, going slow. The bay is just a little, I wouldn't say rough, but it's not flat, you know, it's about a feet, maybe a feet and a half. But good, you know, it's not too windy. These crab pots, you see them? Nightmare, man. I love crabs, but you know, you don't want. You can't have your automatic pilot. You always have to be watching out. Making sure you don't hit one of them. Like there is one there, so I have to go back and release my automatic pilot and escape from her. Man, I had to run and evade that crab pot. If, you know, if you're watching and you are a waterman that works with crab pots, can you please don't put it right in the middle of the channel? I mean, really? Does it have to be right in the middle of the channel? Next to the buoy, you know, the green and red. Come on, guys. Put it a little bit over there, you know? It's the only bad thing, but otherwise, nice ride. All right, don't you hate it when the weather looks amazing, the radar is clear, the weather's website and weather predictions are zero possibility of rain, right? And then all of a sudden you see a dark cloud and you double check your radar and something pops up, right, baby? Big red storm pops up out of nowhere. There is nothing on the sky than the whole radar for hundreds of miles, and all of a sudden this pops up out of nowhere, and then we got rain, we got a storm pops up. He almost hit us a little bit. We were wet, but we immediately veered course. I mean, we're gonna have to go the other way, so we're going away from our destination now, away from the storm. Look at that. So we're gonna wait like half an hour. The storm is moving fast, so it's gonna go away. There's nothing behind it, and we're gonna take our destination again. But this is part of navigating, right, baby? Part of being in the water. Always checking the weather. Always. When I say always, I mean every half an hour. All right, over. So the storm created kind of some rough seas. I don't know if you can see it. Usually the camera doesn't make it justice, but check it out. Look at that. Look at those waves. I don't know if you can see them, but you're talking about 4 footers, almost five footers. Easy. Look at that. But following sea, so you know, I'm going the same direction as the waves. So usually that's pretty good, unless they are super big, that it becomes dangerous. But usually it's very comfortable. I'm going slow, almost at the same speed of the waves. So no problem. Woo! All right. So a great thing about this boat. You know, we're trying to go trawler speed, like a sailboat, you know, dealing with the storm, trying to predict the storm, the waves, dealing with the waves that grow with the storm and the direction of the waves. And you try to deal with the direction of the waves, you know, like a sailboat, all the things that you gotta worry about, the direction of the wind, the direction of the waves, the speed. And, you know, we're doing that for a while, and then the storms keep popping up here and popping up there, and it becomes completely unpredictable. And then we go, you know what, this is a Swiss trawler, so let's make it Swiss, right, baby? And look at that, you make it Swiss 20 knots an hour, 19-18 knots an hour, becomes powerful. You trim it here and boom, it takes the waves, it takes the storm, it takes everything head on, no problem. You know, unless it's a gale, any normal storm, no problem. It takes it head on, the waves, head on or whatever. You know, right now we are they are behind us, so it's good. But we're going fast. We're gonna get there fast. That's it, baby. I try to be conserving gas and go slow and enjoy the ride, but you know, storms. And you know, pissing me off. That's it. Make a sweeps. Woo! Good job, Benito. Baby, we made it to Annapolis. No problem. Storms and everything. Check it out. Made it enough time to get a bite, feeling water. The baby took a shower. Look at that. We got some really good meat from Mission Barbecue. We love Mission Barbecue. It's good meat at an affordable price. And that's it, baby. It's gonna be our dinner. We sit here at the wall at this time, you know, after 8. No one is around, so we're gonna be here until after dinner. At about 10, we're gonna go and grab a mooring ball and spend the night there. And we're gonna be happy. I'm gonna be happy. Are you gonna be happy, baby? Yeah! Woo! Look at this! Dry ribs and brisket. Moist brisket. Nice!
Thank you for watching. We hope these videos have helped promote the Chesapeake Bay. If you're new to our channel, check out our introduction video. Also, help us promote the Chesapeake Bay by giving this video a like and subscribe.